Good morning, children. Today, let's wind up our second unit. Are you ready for the class? Then please take your main course book. Take page number 24. Let's read this first and then we can do the enrichment activities on the next page. Okay? A was an ant. This is a simple poem written by Edward Lear. You can see the name of the poet at the bottom of the page. Who is Edward Lear? Edward Lear is a famous English poet, author, musician and artist. Okay, Edward Lear is a famous English poet, author, musician and artist. He has written a number of poems and stories. So, this is one of his poems. This poem is about the first five letters of English alphabet. This poem is about the first five letters of English alphabet. Children, do you know the difference between letters and alphabet? Is there any difference between alphabet and letters, or are they same? No, they are not same. They are different. What do you mean by an alphabet? Alphabet refers to a set of letters in a language. Alphabet refers to a set of letters in a language. English alphabet consists of 26 letters. In Malayalam, we say Aksharamala for alphabet. Alphabet means Aksharamala. Letters means Aksharangal. English Aksharamalayile 26 Aksharangal undu. There are 26 letters in English alphabet. Alphabet and letters are different. Aksharamalayum Aksharangalum rendu rendalle. They are different. Okay. I hope it's clear. Now, let's read this poem. A. A was an ant who seldom stood still and who made a nice house in the side of a hill. Nice little ant. So, the letter A stands for ant. A was an ant who seldom stood still. What do you mean by seldom? Seldom means, the meaning is given here, hardly ever. Aburvamai. Okay, seldom means aburvamai. A was an ant who seldom stood still. Have you ever noticed ants standing still? Have you ever noticed an ant standing still? Urumbukal anangada evidengil nilkuna kandittundo? We always find them moving and moving. They keep on moving. We don't usually find them standing still. So, they seldom stood still. Avar aburamayite verde nilkarullo. Urumbukal aburamayite verde nilkarullo. Avar eppozhum move cheyondirikkiyana. Ningikondirikkiyana. Anangikondirikkiyana. And who made a nice house in the side of a hill. Nice little ant. You can see the picture of an ant. And you can see the picture of a hill. A hill. Kunnu. Okay, the ant is making, the ant is building a nice house, a beautiful house in the side of a hill. Did you see it in the picture? Well, now, let's read the next stanza. B. B was a book with a binding of blue. So, the second letter of English alphabet, B, stands for book. B was a book with a binding of blue. What do you mean by binding? Binding means a hard cover that keeps the pages of a book together. Okay, the hard cover that keeps the pages of a book together. Puramchatta. Book inde puramchatta. Okay, so the book mentioned in this poem has got a blue binding. It has got a blue cover. Okay. And pictures and stories for me and for you. Nice little book. What does this book contain? Inside this book, we can see many pictures and stories. There are many pictures and stories in this book for me and for you to read. Okay. There are many pictures and stories for us to read in this book. Nice little book. This is a very nice book. This is a good book. Then, moving on to a third stanza. C. C was a cat who ran after a rat. But his courage did fail when she seized on his tail. Crafty old cat. So, C stands for cat. C was a cat who ran after a rat. You can see the picture of a cat running after a rat. We know that cat and rat are enemies. Cat usually caught hold of rat and eat it. Okay. C was a cat who ran after a rat. But his courage did fail when she seized on his tail. But his courage did fail. Courage means bravery, dhairyam. But his courage did fail. Avante dhairyam chornu poi. Aarude? Rat. His refers to rats. Okay. The rat's courage failed. The rat lost its courage. Why? Because the cat seized on his tail. Seized on means, the meaning is given here, caught hold of. The cat caught hold of the rat's tail. The cat caught the rat's tail. You can see it in the picture. So, as the cat caught hold of the rat's tail, the rat's courage failed. Crafty old cat. The old cat is very crafty. What do you mean by crafty? Clever and sly. The cat is very clever. Buddhimanaya pucha. Okay. The cat is very clever. The cat is very brilliant. He is very crafty. Crafty means clever. Buddhimanaya cat. Next. D was a duck. D stands for duck. You can see the picture of a duck with spots on his back. There are spots, pulligal, on his back, who lived in the water and always said quack, dear little duck. What is the sound produced by a duck? Quack, quack. Okay. Duck always say quack, quack. What do you call the young one of a duck? What do we call the young one of a duck? What do we call the children of a duck? The children of a duck are called duckling. Okay, ducklings. Duckling. Tharav kunyangal. Duckling. D was a duck with spots on his back who lived in the water. Ducks usually live in water. They can move on land as well as in water. They can live both in water and in land. D was a duck with spots on his back who lived in the water and always said quack, dear little duck. Then E. E was an elephant. E stands for elephant. Stately and wise. What do you mean by stately? Stately means large and majestic. An elephant is very large, isn't it? An elephant is large, huge. And majestic. What do you mean by wise? Wise means buddhimanaya, vivegamulla. Okay. So the elephant is both large and wise. The elephant is both stately and wise. He had tusk and a trunk. What do you mean by tusk? Elephant has got ivory tusk. Tusk means anakumba. Then trunk. Trunk, tumbikai. The elephant had tusk and a trunk. The elephant has got two tusks. Randa anakumbum, oru thumbikai undu. Two tusks and a trunk. And two cure little eyes. Two cure. What do you mean by cure? Cure means strange, odd, strange, vijitramaya.
The elephant has got two cute little eyes. Oh, what funny small eyes. It's very funny. It's very strange to see the eyes of the elephant. Have you ever noticed the eyes of the elephant? Eyes of an elephant? They are very small. It's funny to see that. It's funny to think that an animal so huge, so big has got two little eyes. Okay? Two small eyes. A huge animal has got two small eyes. It's very funny, isn't it? So this is all about the poem. Can you find any rhyming words in this poem? What do you mean by rhyming words? Rhyming words are the words which end in the same sound. Okay? Which end with the same sound. Words ending with same sounds are called rhyming words. I repeat, words ending with same sounds are called rhyming words. For example, look at this stanza. See, cat, rat. Cat, rat. These two words end with the same sounds. Cat, rat, at. Okay. Both these words end with the sounds at. Okay. So, cat and rat are rhyming words. Similarly, look at the next two lines. Fail, tail. Fail, tail. These two words again end with the same sound. So, these two words, fail and tail, are rhyming words. Okay? In order to find out the rhyming words, we should look at the end of the lines. We need to look at the ending of the lines. Then the words ending with the same sounds are called rhyming words. Okay? I hope it is clear to you. Then, please read this poem several times. Okay? Please read this poem several times. During our Google Meet session, I will ask you to read this poem. Enrichment activities for lessons 1, 2. Shall we do this? Okay. You can change the word rug to bat by changing one letter at a time. See, we need to change the word rug to bat by changing one letter at a time. Okay, by changing one letter of this word at a time, we need to change this word to bat. See how this is done. Rug. The second word is bug. The first letter, only the first letter is changed. Instead of R, they wrote B. Then, look at the third word, bag. In this case, the middle letter, the second letter is changed. The rest two letters are kept same. Okay. The rest two letters remain same, whereas the second letter is changed. Bag. Then look at the third word. The first letter and second letter remain the same, and the third letter is changed. Bat. T. Okay. So in this way, the word rug is changed to bat. Okay. Similarly, we need to change these words. Okay, by changing one letter at a time. First word, hen. We need to change the word hen into dig. Okay, I will give you two examples. Please observe this carefully. Okay, hen. First word is hen. How can we change this into dig? First of all, we can change the first word. Instead of H, we can write
we need to convert hen to dig, no? So we can change the first letter to D. D. Then, by keeping the remaining two letters the same, then. Third word, we can change the second letter. Din. Then, finally, we can change the last letter, dig. See, we have converted hen to dig. Okay? Now, I will do the last one also. Pin. We need to change pin to bat. Pin. So, the first word is pin. Then, we need to change this to bat. So, let's change the first letter. Bin. Then, third word, we can change the third letter. Bit. Then, finally, we can change the second letter. Bat. Okay? We can change any letter. Okay? The only rule is that we should change only one letter at a time. Okay, we should change only one letter at a time. There are two more words to be converted. Can you do this on your own? Please try. Okay? Please try to do it. I will give you the answers in the evening. Then, you can write the answer for this question in your notebook. Next one. Tell your partner how you feel. This is a speaking exercise. We can do this during our Google Meet session. You need not write this in your notebook. Okay? This is a speaking activity. Tell your partner how you feel when you have a new storybook to read. Have nothing to do. Walk in a crowded market. I will ask you how you feel when you get a new storybook, or when you have nothing to do, or when you walk in a crowded market. You can share your feelings with your friends during our evening class. Okay? I will tell you how to answer these questions. First one, have a new storybook to read. My answer is that I feel very happy and excited whenever I get a new storybook to read. I look at the cover of the book and quickly turn over the pages. I just cannot wait to begin reading it. This is my answer. You can have your own answers. Okay. If you feel bored or if you don't like reading a book, you can tell it honestly. Okay. You can share your own feelings. Feel free to share your feelings with your friends. Okay. Share your feelings in one or two sentences. Then, second one, have nothing to do. My answer is that I feel very restless if I do not have anything to do. I sit at the window and look at the people walking outside. Sometimes I go up to the terrace and look out at the city. Okay? This is my answer. You can have your own answers. Then third one, walk in a crowded market. I do not like to walk in a crowded market with people pushing me from all sides. Although my mother takes me to the market with her, I do not like to visit a fruit or vegetable market. I wish to return home as soon as I can. If you are very interested to walk in a crowded market, then you can write it in that way. Okay? Just write one or two sentences. That's enough. Then, now make a list of three things that you enjoy doing don't enjoy doing, normally do when you are bored. Okay, now you can write three things that you enjoy doing. List out three things. Take your notebook and write down three activities that you like doing. And write down three activities that you do not like doing. And write any three things that you normally do when you are bored. What you do when you feel bored. Okay? Just make a list of three things. My answer is, under the title I enjoy, I write reading, listening to music, painting. Then under the heading I don't enjoy, I write sitting idle, watching horror films, eating junk food. Then under the heading when I am bored, I write I listen to music, I call up my best friend, I talk to my mother. These are my answers. You can write your own answers. Okay. Share your list with the class. Say why you enjoy or do not enjoy the things on your list. You need not write down the reasons in your notebook. You can just tell the reasons during our evening class. Okay. Then, next question. We all love receiving gifts. There are many kinds of gifts. A kind word or an action, a book or a toy are all gifts. We all like to receive presents, don't we? നമുക്കെല്ലാവർക്കും gifts കിട്ടാൻ ഇഷ്ടമാണ്. We all like to receive gifts. There are many kinds of gifts. Gifts are of different types. There are different types of gifts. A kind word or an action. ഒരു നല്ല വാക്കോ നല്ല പ്രവൃത്തിയോ, a book or a toy are all gifts. All these are gifts. If you were to choose a gift for your grandparent, what would you choose? The list below may help you. Write a sentence about why you chose that particular present. Children, just imagine that you want to give a present to your grandparent. Okay? You want to give a gift to your grandparent. Then, what gift will you give? What would you choose? There is a small list given below. You can choose a gift from this list. Or you can select any other gifts. Okay? Just write a sentence. Write one sentence about why you chose that particular gift. Okay? Which gift will you give to your grandparent? Okay. The options given here are a book, a card, chocolates, a potted plant, a jute bag, anything else. My answer is, I would love to give a potted plant to my grandmother. She is very fond of growing plants. She would water the plant every day and watch it grow. That would make her very happy and she would remember me every day. This is my answer. You need not write lengthy sentences and all. Just try to write this. Okay? If you are able to write only one sentence, okay, then that's enough. Okay? Just try. When you're sad, how do you look? When you're happy, how do you look? Draw your sad and happy faces. This is optional. I won't compel you to do this. If you are interested to draw your happy and sad faces, then you can. Okay? It's not compulsory. You can do if you want. Okay? If you are interested, you can draw your happy and sad faces.